And to start off, I want to apologize. This is my freak show right here. So I want to thank everybody for coming out. It's important in this scene, especially in an open mic setting, that people, especially like your family and friends, come out and see you. It's hard to develop a talent when you're basically singing to an empty room. And I think a lot of us know how that is. Anything that you're interested in, it's hard to be passionate about something when you feel like you're the only one doing it, or the only one into it, or the only one trying. I have some friends that actually drove 2 hours tonight to see me perform for the first time from Illinois, and I want to thank the Heralds. Thank you very much for coming. I was thinking about this on the way here, like, you drove 2 hours to watch a man you barely know perform. It's a lot like dating in college. I think we've all done that at some point in our life, went a little bit too far out of your way for a little bit too short of a payoff. So we got any NFL fans in here tonight? So we all heard, it's weird, especially coming from a white guy. So you guys know who Russell Wilson is, right? The quarterback of the Seattle Seahawks. He's a really good football player. So recently it came out that he was having problems with his team on the rumor that he isn't black enough. And I can kind of sympathize. I'm a white guy and a rap fan, and often I'm not black enough. So did anybody vote yesterday?
Yeah.
No, is that a Republican woo? Democrats? Nobody? We're not clapping either way? We're not identifying?
You lost.
That's fantastic. We are in Carmel, so if you're Democrat, that would be considered enemy territory. Speaking of Hamilton County, I think it's fantastic. They're putting in roundabouts everywhere. And I gave up on 465 as a route to work. So now I take back roads and I cross, like, I don't know, half dozen four-way stops. I've got this figured out. They keep putting in roundabouts because we keep fucking up four-way stops. Okay? Pro tip, if you and the person across from you, if it's your turn, you can both go at the same time. Did you know that? Is this on? Did you know that? You can both go. You don't have to fucking sit there and flip a fucking coin or flip your cigarette at the other car like, dude, go, I'm being nice. You can both go. It's fantastic. So I gotta tell you a story. I got called a fag at the grocery store the other day. I know it's fucked. I'm wearing Argyle cheap shot, right? So it's a Sunday. To be completely honest, women throw you off altogether. I thought my girlfriend was on her period. She was just like, we go to the grocery store, give me something sweet. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go set the week up right. I'm gonna go to the grocery store. It was like 70 degrees, it had been shitty all week. It was like 40 or less and like windy as hell, it just sucked. It was like 70 degrees. Didn't think a thing about it, it was right before I came to your house. So I go to the grocery store and walk through the grocery store. And this inbred looking motherfucker just goes, fag, like deadpan, right in the fucking eyeballs. I was like, shit, I wanted to protest. Like, I wanted to say something. And like, all that came to my brain was like, purple's a fucking color of royalty. Like, what's wrong with you? Which is obviously not the fucking thing to say. Like, he would have got it anyway. But the thing about it was that I didn't think about my outfit before I left because, well, goddamn it, it's 2014. I'm like, Jesus, really? I'm 6'3", I got a beard. You don't grow this to put it in a dude's ass, right? So, am I wrong? So obviously I was wearing a purple polo, right? Wearing a purple polo and Bermuda shorts and fucking flip-flops. I did not plan the outfit. It wasn't like I was like, you know what, I want to look like a perceived fruit today and go to the fucking grocery store. And what made matters worse, so obviously I didn't like retort, because not only dude was like my size, but I was carrying like a hand basket underhanded, and I had like pumpkin spice creamer and Greek yogurt and candy apples and 2 pints of fucking ice cream. By the way, I got laid. Just saying. But, so I'm like full effort, not even think about it. And Well, I think the only thing that like could have made it a little more obvious if I put the Ray-Bans on top of my head, but I had them like tucked into the polo. I was fine. Like, as soon as he said fag, I was just like, he's inbred. That's just the way this works. Like, you're uneducated, and I obviously had a clean polo. So, we'll take it. Fantastic, I got a light. It's a little early. It's all right. So I got two jokes. So I become a big fan of eugenics, and I'm glad the dude that went two before me whiffed on his baby honey boo-boo bit. So I become a big fan of eugenics. Okay, nobody said anything. So that means none of you know what eugenics is, and that's fantastic, and this is a comedy club, pretty predictable shit. Eugenics is the theory that we need to improve the genetic quality of the human race. Honey boo-boo, which is actually Mama June, is a perfect fucking example of why we need eugenics, right? Like, obviously, any person willing to whore their children out on national television in exchange for money, who then decides, you know what? I think I'm gonna date a fucking convicted sex offender and a child molester. Like, that's perfect logic. This is why you need to improve the genetic quality of the human race, on top of which, if you Google Mama June, put that mental image in your head and just go, damn, that's fantastic. Just a big old lady, what the fuck ever, dude. I'm not up here to fat shame. Leave that to somebody else. Now, if you've ever seen Spawn and you know who the Violator is, you can Google that image, put them side by side, and then try to be the guy that fucked that girl. Like, and try not to have nightmares the rest of your fucking life. Like, seriously? Anyway, that's my time. Thank you for coming out tonight.